Hello friends, my name is Mansi Anand and I'm going to be taking your marketing lecture. The knowledge of marketing is very useful to you. It would help you in preparation of many exams. And if you like this video, then do subscribe to our channel and you can also join our Telegram group for more such related updates. So let's start with marketing. So now we're going to study evolution of marketing. So before studying evolution of marketing, we should understand the meaning of evolution. What is evolution? Evolution means journey or change of a concept from different time periods. How the concept has changed, how people's views and perceptions regarding that concept has changed pertains to evolution. That is what is called evolution. How a concept has come into its current state or form, changing from different time periods. So we are going to know about evolution of marketing, how marketing came in its current form that we are studying. So we are going to study this journey of marketing from late 1800s to the current time. First of all, I would like to tell you that marketing used to be product oriented. Product oriented means the focus was on the quality and quantity of the product. Here marketers used to believe that if we develop a product which is good in quality and is appropriately priced and is in the affordability range of the customer is gonna come and buy the product really easily. So that is how marketing used to be product oriented. The entire focus of marketing lied on the quality and quantity of product. So now marketers have moved forward to different concepts. So from being product oriented, now marketing has come to being sales oriented. Now what do we mean by sales orientation? Here in sales orientation, the entire focus used to be on selling the product. The marketer has produced a product which would fulfill the needs of the consumer. But now the main point is how to persuade that consumer to buy the product that marketer has prepared. So that is what is sales orientation. The entire focus lies on selling the product and transferring the ownership of the product from the marketer to the consumer. So earlier industries used to be product oriented, but slowly and gradually they progressed to being sales oriented. After sales orientation, marketing moved to being market oriented. Now what do we mean by being market oriented? So being market oriented means developing a product or a service which is in accordance with the needs of the consumer who is going to consume the product later. So when we were studying about marketing in the earlier video, we studied one of the basic feature of marketing is that marketing is very consumer or customer oriented. So the marketer has to study about the needs and wants of the consumer, develop a product in accordance with that, a product which fulfills the needs of market, the needs of consumers, and then think about transferring product to the consumer. So this is the journey of marketing from being product oriented to sales oriented to market oriented. So currently the theories, the principles that we study in marketing are more in accordance with market orientation. So now marketers believe that it is very important to precede production and start marketing much earlier than the actual production of the product. And also the work of marketers nowadays does not end with the transfer of ownership of product from marketer to consumer. It still goes on in the form of after sale services, in the form of monitoring the response of consumers, and then developing further strategies. So these are the different orientations of marketing. Now coming to marketing concepts. So marketing concepts can be divided into two parts, traditional concepts and modern concepts. Under traditional concepts, we are going to study the exchange concept, the production concept, the product concept, and the selling concept. And under the modern concepts, we are going to study the marketing concept, the holistic marketing concept, and the social marketing concept. So let us move forward and understand each of this concept in further detail. So first concept is the exchange concept. It is very simple and very basic. It holds that exchange of product between the buyer and seller is the central idea of marketing. So under features of marketing, first feature was that exchange is the basic essence of marketing. So this concept holds that there are two parties, the marketer and the consumer, and there is an exchange transaction going on between these two parties, and this is what marketing is all about. So moving further to the next concept, the production concept. So production concept, it holds that consumer prefer products that are widely available and inexpensive. So under this concept, the entire focus of the marketer is on availing economies of scale so that the marketer can produce an inexpensive product. So here the marketer believes that if the marketer would be able to produce or manufacture a low-cost product, the product can easily be widely available to the consumer. And if the product is widely available to the consumer is gonna buy more and more of it. Also, if there would be production of that product in large numbers, in large quantities, then the cost of production is gonna go down. So the consumer would be easily able to buy an inexpensive product. So here, the focus is on reducing the cost of product for the consumer so that the consumer buys more and more of the product. So focus is on achieving high production efficiency, low costs, and mass distribution of the products. So the producers who want to expand their level of business, who wants to enter into new fields by expanding their business, for them this concept holds true. They can produce on a large scale, they can engage in mass distribution of the product, they can find new markets for their products so that the product is widely available to the consumer. And by achieving economies of scale, the producer can easily reduce the cost of production and increase his or her profit margin. So this concept usually makes sense in a developing country. We can take, for example, China. So why in a developing country? Because in developing countries, there is huge potential for demand. The population is usually growing, the GDP is usually increasing. So with increasing level of income of the population in a developing country, this concept makes sense as people would be able to buy more and more of a product and demand more of the product. Whereas in a developed country, the demand might be saturated and it would not be that easy to increase the demand in high numbers. So in a developing country, this concept makes sense. Also, there is one more reason why developing countries hold to this concept. Usually in developing countries, there is huge and inexpensive labor pool available. So the producer would be easily able to find low cost labor, which would in turn result in an inexpensive product. So there are two reasons why production concept makes sense in developing countries. The company Legend, which is a very famous PC manufacturer, hold to this concept. This concept also holds relevance for products where demand usually exceeds their supply. So the demand is high, so there is requirement of production of that product on a large scale so that the producer would be able to manufacture a low cost product which can easily be made widely available to the consumer. So the focus is on creating inexpensive, high quality product rather than focusing on finding the right customer. I hope you're clear with this concept. And moving forward to the product concept. So here in production concept, the main focus was on quantity of the product, whereas in product concept, the main focus is on the quality of the product. So let's say there is a company which has a lot of confidence on the quality of its product. We can say that that company is adhering to the product concept. So here the producers are really confident about the quality of their product. So there is one issue in this concept which usually marketers face, which is called better mousetrap fallacy. So what does this better mousetrap fallacy means? It means that the producers, usually they fall in love with their product, they think that their product is really supreme and they do not have to put any efforts in making this product available to the consumer. The consumer would come and buy the product just because of its high quality. So here a problem arises that product might be really great in its quality, but it is not necessary that the consumer will come and buy it. It is very, very important to price it, distribute it, advertise it, and selling it properly so that the consumer would become aware of the product. Moving forward to the selling concept. Here in selling concept, the main focus is on sales. How to increase sales. So here the marketer thinks about increasing the number of his sold products. So this concept assumes that the customer is not gonna buy enough of a product if he or she is not persuaded to do so. So the marketer tries to engage in any effort to make the consumer aware about the product and increasing the number of sales. In cases of goods like cemetery plots and insurance products, which are usually called unsought goods. So these are the products which the consumer usually doesn't think of buying. It's not like I'm going to shopping and I will think that let's buy an insurance policy. No one does that. So these are the products, unsought goods are the products which usually the customer does not think of buying on a routine basis, on a regular basis. So the consumer has to be persuaded, or the consumer has to be made aware about the benefits of such products, so the consumer becomes interested in buying the product. So here the focus is on trying to sell what the marketer has made rather than making the product that the market or the consumer wants. But the problem with this concept is, here marketers believe that if you force a consumer to buy such product, they're not gonna badmouth it, they're not gonna do a bad publicity about such products, but they might buy the product again, which is not true. If a consumer is forced into buying a product which is not as per his or her needs, they might badmouth it and they might not buy again and prevent others from buying it too. So this is the problem with this concept. Now moving forward to the marketing concept. So this marketing concept believes in market orientation. So this concept, it emerged around 1950s. So the basic funda or the basic principle involved in this concept is, it is customer centered. It holds on feature of marketing that customer is the god of market. Sense and respond philosophy. So what is this sense and respond philosophy? First, the marketer has to sense the needs of the market or the consumer and then respond with value offerings in accordance with these needs. So marketing concept, it focuses on being customer centered, on being consumer oriented, and it believes in sense and respond philosophy. First, research your market. First, research about your target audience. What products do they desire? What needs do they have? Do the current products which are available in market, do they fulfill customers' need? So these are the things that the marketer has to research about and then respond by developing a value offering or a product or a service which would fulfill the needs of consumers. Here, the job is not to find the right customer for your product, but the right product for your customers. So don't think about persuading the consumer to buy the product, but produce a product which would fulfill the needs of customers, that they can be persuaded to buy the product. So Dell, a very famous laptop manufacturer. So Dell does not prepare perfect laptops for their customers. They engage in providing the customer with a platform where they can come and each person, each customer can customize the laptops in accordance with their needs, in accordance with the requirements that a customer desires in their computer. So this is the basic difference between selling and marketing, that selling focuses on the needs of the seller, whereas marketing, it focuses on the needs of the buyer or the consumer or the person who is ultimately going to use the product. So this is the basic difference between the selling concept and the marketing concept. So marketing believes in creating, delivering, and communicating superior customer value to the consumer. Now moving forward to the holistic marketing concept. So holistic marketing concept, as the name in itself tells us, holistic, including everything. According to this concept, everything matters in marketing. Everything that affects the business of a company, everything that affects the motives behind the purchase of consumers. So everything in the interaction between the consumer and the producer, everything matters. And the marketer has to take care about everything. So holistic marketing concept, you can see in this diagram, it comprises of four parts: internal marketing, integrated marketing, socially responsible marketing, and relationship marketing. Now we are going to study each component in its detail. First of all, relationship marketing. So relationship marketing tells us that the company needs to build relationship with everyone, with every party that it deals with. So satisfying long-term relationship with key constituents such as customers, employees, marketing partners, which include suppliers, dealers, agencies, distributors, in order to earn and retain the people and organizations that directly or indirectly affect the success of the firm's marketing activities. So this concept believes that the company involves in a lot of transactions with a various number of parties. So it needs to build long-term good relationship with those parties which affect its business. When a company gets involved in relationship marketing, it builds a unique asset which is called marketing network. So when a company has good relationship, good terms with different parties like its suppliers, its customers, its employees, all those people work together with the company to fulfill the objectives of that company. So it is very important to build good relationships with them so that you can coordinate with them to fulfill your own objectives. It includes CRM, which is customer relationship management, and PRM, partner relationship management. We're going to study these two concepts in detail in further videos. Now coming to integrated marketing. Integrated marketing holds that the whole is greater than the sum of its part, which means that all the activities that go on in marketing in different departments of the companies, all those activities have to be coordinated in such a way that it results in fulfilling the objectives of marketing. So there are different activities that a company fulfills in the process of transferring the product from company to the consumer, including pricing, communicating, producing the product, the technical aspects of producing the product, deciding on different channels, deciding on different promotional tools. So basically these all are individual activities, these all are distinct activities, but they cannot go on with different set of objectives. Ultimately, they have to be coordinated in such a way that the objectives of the marketers are being fulfilled. So it is very important to coordinate different activities in a department, in different departments of a company, because all those departments collectively deliver customer value to the consumer. So it is very important to coordinate their activities. Then only the company would be able to create, communicate and deliver values to the customer. So it entails that communication strategy of a company, channel strategy, all these strategies should be aligned with the products or services that the company normally deals in. That is, all activities must be integrated. Now coming to internal marketing. So internal marketing, it is the task of hiring, training, motivating able employees who want to serve the customers well. So basically, internal marketing, as the name suggests, focusing on the internal parts of the company. And who lies on the internal parts of companies? Employees. Be it senior management, middle management, or lower level employees. So internal marketing focuses on coordinating the activities and the objectives of employees, so employees work wholeheartedly towards achieving the objectives of the company. So here in internal marketing, the special focus is on senior management, because senior management, the people who form the senior management, they are the people who decide on various strategies of the company, on different policies that have to be formed, different actions that a company has to take. The middle and lower level employees, they are usually following the orders of the senior level employees. So the main focus, the main responsibility, the main accountability lies on the senior management, and their main responsibility is coordinating marketing activities within the company. So requires vertical alignment, as I told you above, between senior, middle and lower level employees, and horizontal alignment between different departments. So they can be a marketing department, they can be an accounts department, can be a technical department, they can be different departments in the company which work on the same level of production, and all those have to be aligned to fulfill the objectives of internal marketing. Now the last component of holistic marketing concept, that is the performance marketing. So performance marketing focuses on understanding the effects of all those activities that a company engages in. So can be divided into financial and non-financial returns to business and the society from marketing activities and programs of a company. So whatever activities that the company engages in, whatever activities it does to fulfill its own objectives or to fulfill its social responsibilities, so performance marketing analyzes or understands all the impacts that a company is having on society and on itself also. Performance marketing can be divided into two parts: financial accountability and social responsibility marketing. Under financial accountability, the company is accountable to its investors who have invested their hard-earned money into the company for its growth and expansion. So here the marketers, they have to answer to these investors that what is the company doing, or what are the activities that a company is engaging in, and what kind of impact would those activities have on investments of these investors. So here in financial accountability, different financial measures like market share, customer loss rate are analyzed to understand the financial performance of a company. Now coming to social responsibility marketing, here the name itself tells us that marketers must consider the ethical, environmental, legal and social context of their roles and activities. That is, the company must understand what kind of impact is it having on society in different forms, especially on environment, and is the company fulfilling its social responsibilities or not. For this, usually a company engages in CSR activities, that is corporate social responsibility activities. So this assumes that a company or a business, it derives its inputs from the society. Without functioning in the society, a business cannot flourish. So since it is deriving its inputs from the society, the company should also analyze the effects of its output on the society. What kind of impact is the company having on the society? So if a company is engaged in building a hospital for poor or a school for poor children or in some infrastructural projects important for the economy, the company is engaging in social responsibility marketing. So there is a very good example of social responsibility marketing, which is Jaipur Foot. So there is an organization in Jaipur which is called Bhagwan Mahavir Viklang Sahayata Samiti. It was established in 1975. So this organization developed a prosthetic limb. So they realized there is a lot of need for prosthetic limbs in country, but due to affordability reasons, due to high cost of these sort of treatments, people are not usually able to avail these treatments. So they developed a prosthetic limb of good quality which would be made affordable to people. So this prosthetic limb was designed to be inexpensive, quick to fit and water resistant. So the design of this limb was made in such a manner that it is very easy to manufacture it and it can avail the economies of scale. That is why it can be provided to the needy people at affordable prices. So in today's video, we learned about different concepts of marketing. I hope you understood them. And if you like this video, please do subscribe to our channel and keep getting such updates. Thank you.